I mean,
so as someone who's more used to the game, I really like the invasions because they show up. They're usually rare, and they show up as like a surprise encounter that like mixes things up and adds a memorable emergent encounter to the experience.
Yeah,
kind of like how PUBG, like when you're playing PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, like just the experience is all the weird variables that come together to form a thing that hasn't happened before. And so like the PvP encounters can be incredibly memorable, but right now you mostly just stand there and die.
Yeah,
like,
well,
new players never know what the fuck to even do. Grab there's an item.
I would love to.
Item in the grading.
Like, okay, I'll give you that, but like at least just a prompt.
There was an item in the grading.
Oh.
he kept going.
I mean, I don't know, just a casual prompt of like, hey, look, someone wants to invade you. Are you okay with that? And just like, no, I'm not. I'm in the middle of something.
Was that it? That might have been the key you needed. You got a sewer chamber key, is what it was called. Did you read the name at all?
Use this key to see for yourself. Let's see. Key to the sewer chamber in the depths.
That's a little vague.
Well, do you not want me to fight the rat boss?
No, maybe try the upstairs door, just to see if it opens.
Okay. Well, I figure that's a way to go. What, I'm supposed to jump down onto the rat? Oh, God. Fucking geometry. let's see. Yep. Sewer chamber key.
There you go.
Oh, it's a bonfire.
Yeah, that's why I was like, oh, check out that door. Oh, fuck. Like, I was like surprised it was locked. I forgot about that detail. Wait, that's trying to help you out here. Something to find. You have a lot of souls.
I do have a lot of souls. I guess I'll rest at a bane farm.
Yeah, it'll just bring back a couple rats. They're easy.
Let's see. Almost enough.
Almost enough for twice again. Almost.
I guess.
So you're still getting 30 health per level up.
Yeah, but I should probably. No, strength is only 4. That sucks.
Only 4? It's only 1 less than before. It's still a pretty good bonus, actually. Now that you've ranked up your club, it went from being like a +3 or whatever to being a +4 because you ranked up at scaling too.
But I could rank up my club to be a +10.
Yeah. And then scaling's retroactive too.
Mm.
It's just based on your current strength. So every time you, like, it's +4 now, but yeah, it might be plus more in the long run when you add, because when you, every time you level up the weapon, its scaling levels up too, which is why the plus number also goes up more. So you could keep busting up your damage, or you could keep getting more health and more stamina. Those are the three things that really help right now.
Yeah.
And there's other options. Dexterity gives you other builds you could potentially go down and stuff like that, but yeah.
Literally just a guy hanging out here.
So that explains why I don't remember at all that door being locked and there being like a key needed for it, because it's such a tiny hurdle. You go down on one hallway and it's there.
Yeah.
So I've probably forgotten about that every single time. So interestingly, the game doesn't. Oh no.
Are you fucking joking? Like in a second. In a second.
You got hit by all of them at once, basically.
But I couldn't fucking even. Oh wait.
Yeah, you got it equipped already. It's the normal one. There
Purple.
You go. Yeah.
God, fuck off!
Yeah, the white one's for toxin, I believe. There you go. I mean, he's just gonna reapply it. No, there you go.
God.
Probably should have finished him off first, yeah. Andrew's in a good mood.
This guy
right
literally destroyed
now.
The whole fun of Dark Souls for me.
That PvP here?
Yeah, just instantly.
Should we just be stopping for the day then?
I'm gonna try fighting this rat boss.
You're,
and we're gonna
you're
stop.
Very
he basically
in
just,
a bad mood.
Yeah, he basically just ruined it for me. Cause it's just not fun. It was not fun at all to sit there and just get devastated by a guy.
It's not fun.
Yeah, it's not fun. Don't include it in your fucking game if it's not fucking fun for people. Or make it an option that doesn't require you to turn off the fucking game and return it on. Why would I want to quit my game, turn it off, turn the new feature off, and then turn my fucking game on? That's stupid. What a stupid
you
idea.
You reached like new vocal tones during that.
Like, what a fucking retarded feature.
Those are like some specific sounds of frustration that I've like not heard from you before.
It's like, oh my god, a fucking hoodlum. Get out of here, dude.
Hoodlum. That's the name he's got now.
God damn.
That's great. I'm
not fighting your trident ass.
Look at his creepy, like, rats that are just hanging out. Oh, there they go.
Yeah, you guys can come up here if you want to
fight
me.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Build up that poison meter. Build it up. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to go do this.
That, it just looks like you're on fire at that angle. Yeah, as you progress with the game, the invasions make more sense as a mechanic, but when you're brand new at the game, it's just like the dickest thing. Because you have no tools to work with, you barely know what you're doing as a player.
I've never even summoned.
And the game just crushes you.
Like, you know what? You know what would be even, like, reasonable? Like, a midway point. Like, I'll give it to you. Maybe if I had summoned a live person to help me once.
Yeah.
Then maybe you could say, like, all right. Like, it should have a prompt to go, the moment you do this, you're letting the floodgates open. You can let people invade you, and you can summon as you please. But I didn't.
What's interesting,
ask.
That was like an inch away from being, like, a super memorable moment. Because of the fact that, like, oh, shit. Because of the fact that you were, like, an inch away from summoning a guy. And, like, I was like, oh, well, you ran away because you're unprepared to fight the crazy pyromancer man. But then you summoned fucking Swagger Dude or whatever we saw earlier. That was like a fucking Chekhov's gun. And it turns the tide 2-on-1. And it could have been really cool. But
could have been. If for some reason,
it didn't quite
like, being invaded takes so much quicker than fucking summoning a person.
Large Titanite.
Like, I clicked on summon. And in the time that it took me to barrel roll around that him multiple times, still hadn't summoned that guy.
Yep.
What a fucking travesty.
Trying to set up an online connection and things got in trouble.
Trying to set up an online... It's already set up. Dude's already invading me. This looks like a fucking hell. Like a hell.
Here.
All right,
he says.
Well, I trust you.
Is that a trap anywhere? Look at that hole.
I think it's a lip. No, that's a hole.
Even the water rushing sound is just like, watch out, motherfucker.
Well, it didn't work.
No, didn't work out.
Shortcut?
Oh, look, it's where you were earlier.
Wait, what?
Yeah, you never noticed this. there was a side path here. But there's a hole. Oh. 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 Where are you now?
Back at the beginning.
That was an interesting path to go down.
I didn't choose to. I chose to jump.
But not at the beginning. New things. Do not let this meter fill up. I'm just going to say that.
Excuse me?
Do not let the meter fill up.
Interesting.
Do not let that meter fill up. It's such bad
news.
Well,
he's dead, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, he petrifies people. That much I know. Da 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 da. Where the fuck is this rat? I just wanted to get my swing at a goddamn rat, but instead I got a fucking lizard. Hello there, giant rats. Somehow you guys are getting bigger. Did you not? Okay.
What are they putting in this sewer?
You're really agile for some reason.
They're like, bouncy rats. You know, like bounce rats? Oh shit.
Could you have any kind of tell? That'd be great. Like, any ability for me to go like, oh, I guess he's about to jump.
It is a surprisingly abrupt attack.
Like, the thing I was fucking complaining about in Mighty
like,
Number
Blong.
9.
God, Mighty Number 9 is
like,
garbage.
Like, literally every boss, like, the first boss I fought, which was like, the pyro guy, he was like, no, he had no tells.
That rat was in a hurry.
I was like, oh, cool, I love fighting bosses with no tells.
They've taught you not to trust any of these boxes. Because they've been full of rats before.
Full of rats. I don't even know how that happens.
Who's boxing rats? Yeah, these guys are all sorts of different sizes.
How?
Oh, there's the poison.
How?
It's fine. You got that item that you thought was useless before. Although it will run out.
That's not the point. The point is I don't understand how I fucking lunge at a rat, but he takes priority over me.
It doesn't really take priority. You both hit each other simultaneously.
He wasn't even moving.
He didn't stop your hit.
No, but he wasn't fucking, like, moving himself, so all of a sudden he was just like, well, I think I'm just gonna attack immediately.
Might wanna heal.
Might wanna just die.
It's like, that's when you learn, and you're like, oh, well, I gotta bait his attack and then attack him after he attacks. Because if his attack's too fast for you to get the first hit, because that's a part of you playing a strength build, is that is an issue you have to worry about, is that you then try to bait their attack first so you can hit them while they're recovering from their swing. Like, that's how a slow character deals with a fast character. And that's a basic mechanic and strategy you'll have to get used to just to be able to play as a strength character. Because you are slower than some enemies.
Come here. Would you stop?
Pretty sure the rats are specifically trying to get you to get hit by slimes.
They are, but I can't get that one to come down, so... until I can get that one
thankfully,
to come...
Thankfully, slimes are slow as all hell, so you can pretty much just ignore them if you don't like fighting them.
Oh, come on!
You went right under him. Oh, no.
And you can't get these things off.
Nope.
Just... nothing.
I've heard that hammering the triggers or bumpers or something might make them go off a little faster or something, but you can't just, like, get them off.
There's no way I could fight a rat with four fucking SS flasks.
I don't know. Damn. You've done worse with that freaking hammer of yours that just ruins things.
Yeah, it's just fucking, god damn it. I specifically was like avoiding this guy.
Until you went directly under him?
I thought I was not under him. Okay, you guys got what you wanted. Come out. I'm not doing this shit no more. Get the fuck out here.
Just go hit him. Oh, he's leaving. We'll go hit. Oh. He's looking in the corner. If I can't see him, he can't see me. The rats are mischievous here. They're trying to bait you. Howdy. He seems chill.
Hello, Satan. Do you know where you are? Because this is not like a high traffic area.
Nope, but he sells things. Gold pine resin.
That's a good indicator of what I might need for a rat. whoa, excuse me? What is this?
He sells crystal weapons.
Crystal
weapons have real great stats, but they have one fatal flaw. You can't repair them.
For the durability of 60? That's not a very good...
wait, is it crystal or glass? I think it's crystal that can't be repaired. The description probably says it.
Oh, that's a good idea.
So it cannot be used for long and it cannot be repaired.
But how strong is it?
Its crystallization boosts its attack.
I mean, that's pretty
but
good.
It makes it the poopy butts.
I mean, that's a pretty good, like...
yeah, a great sword that you actually have the stats for.
Yeah.
190 plus 65. But then it breaks.
Yeah.
Just in time for you to get used to its moveset, it breaks. And you're like, shit, I was just getting used to that moveset, and now it's gone.
He has a shield, too? Like, I'd want the fucking shield?
Does have 100% block.
Great, but it has...
actually has huge block across the board. And 250 durability, so it'll last a little while. But then it's gone. And it goes bye-bye.
Speaking of which, how is
I've never
my...
used the I've never even purchased the crystal weapons, I don't
how,
think.
How is my... stop. Stop talking to me. Seriously, stop. Stop, could you just... Jesus Christ. Alright,
Andrew hates NPCs.
Yeah, too. I mean,
I'm not crazy. It's not a 100% block shield.
What?
This shield's on. It has 95% block.
Oh, god damn it! Fuck this shield.
I was noticing you were hitting. You're getting hit by guys, and there was like a tiny, tiny chip of damage. Sometimes I'm like, where is that coming from? I'm like, your stamina didn't quite drain. I'm like, oh, this is 95% block. That's why you're getting an incredibly ignorable but still present sometimes amount of damage.
I wonder if I should,
There's some options to weigh.
Yeah. I don't know, 95's fine for the stamina that it gives me.
So does that door open right now?
I don't know.
Let's check.
Tears ahead.
It's locked. Okay. So do you understand how to switch, by the way, between things you click on?
What?
Do you understand how to switch between things you click on?
Toggle? You mean?
Yeah.
Like why?
Yeah.
You missed.
I've seen you fight against that mechanic a few times. I'm like, I couldn't tell if you knew it existed or if you heard.
I didn't know it existed, but that I know.
Yeah, if you hit Y to toggle, you switch between all the different things you could potentially press A on.
Boss ahead.
So
where?
So something interesting happened.
Oh, good, it's giant slime.
So because you.
Good, giant.
So, because
slime.
You fell through that hole, you skipped the rat.
What?
Yeah.
Can I get back to him?
When you get back out and stuff. Yeah, you completely skipped the rat.
Fuck, are you serious?
The moment I saw that channeler, I'm like, hang on a minute. He's somewhere else now.
But yeah, but I don't want to fight this.
Well.
Four Estus flasks.
Well, here you are.
Yeah, but if I fucking die, how do I get back down here besides taking the shortcut? And that was a long-ass hike.
Well, you don't have that many souls. You have one level worth, which is by now, like...
I have two humanity that I'm not I'm not losing.
If you're that defensive of it, you could always homeward bone. That's always an option.
Well, apparently this guy had the right idea. Saw a ghost who stand up here and just bow and arrowing it. Smart move. I don't know how you get back up here after you start the boss fight, but... Maybe he's just shooting it from afar?
He was shooting down to the chamber?
God, I really don't want to fight no giant fucking slime. especially with that. Like, this boss area is huge.
It's really big.
And it's big for a reason. Because you need to be... like
It's a very big boss fight chamber.
Apparently this boss does things that need to be avoided. Well, I'm going to do this.
Have fun.
I'm going to go down here. Alright, slowly make my way.
Making your way downstairs.
Yeah, I'm going to see... What do you got to say? Left.
Hey, that's nice of him.
Heavy crossbow and heavy bolt.
There you go. You got a new weapon.
That sounds useful, but can I use it? I can.
So crossbows are one of the options for people that aren't dex builds because they don't require... They don't scale. They're just a flat... They're like the equivalent of like a raw weapon. They just have flat stats.
Oh, shit.
Yep, there it goes. Firing from the hip. What are you trying to do?
Oh, what? You can't aim with this?
Maybe not.
Okay, good to know. Oh, but just wasting some bolts.
Do you fat roll right now with a crossbow? All right, just always want to check.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's the fog gate.
So you cannot summon here.
Well, you're not human. So you can't summon regardless.
Summon NPC?
No, you have to be human to summon anything.
God damn it.
Yep.
This fucking asshole ruined my entire run.
You've been miserable ever since that red flashing message popped out.
I should have just stopped. I should have just quit out of the game immediately. That would have been a smarter option.
Yeah, could be.
Because you can't die when you do that, right?
I don't know, honestly. I've never done that. I'm always recording, which is what we're doing here, I guess, too, where I'm like accountable for my actions, so it's like unsatisfying for the audience for me to just quit out in that moment.
I don't give a fuck about the audience. I give a fuck about how fun I'm having. If I'm not having any fucking fun, then I'm not gonna goddamn do it. Like, if you guys want to fucking play PvP, goddamn buy the fucking game. It's $20.
You're also in a different step where you're in the learning stage, whereas I'm usually not. So the conditions are totally different for me. Look, so I haven't had a reason to test that to see if it would even work or not, or if they could just run up and kill your body when you're standing there or something.
100% promise you, no matter how fucking good I am at this game, I will not play PvP. That is a waste of my time and talents. I'm not going to play fucking losers who are playing a six-year-old fucking game in PvP.
You're trying to make up whether or not going to go in there or not, or if you're going to use a homeward. You still have a homeward bone if you think you need to go back.
I don't want to waste it here. I'd rather waste it just going and grabbing souls and then coming back. What's a better idea?
Well, one thing is, if you think you need a summon that bad, then yeah, you could homeward bone, become human at the bonfire, clear your way here again, summon, and so on.
Eh. Let's give it a fucking whirl, see how this goes.
8,000 souls on the line! Spooky cutscene!
Oh no! It's a crocodile elephant! Snake. Nope, just a crocodile elephant. Spider. Man. Cthulhu. Maybe I should have summoned.
This boss is a reveal. It's the most bizarre sight.
Oh. So watch out for slams.
Eek.
Come on, slam.
It's called the Gaping Dragon.
Weakness is its head. Yeah, I could see that. Oh, it also destroyed a pillar in one swing.
So it slammed down and destroyed the entire
pillar. Apparently it also has onto it?
It also has a charge. There it goes. Oh, there.
I charged you. I'm just wondering real quick, is there a way I can lock onto you? No, okay. What do you got? Hey. Thanks for all that armor now?
In the middle of a boss fight? I guess the guy died here.
Yeah.
Lore. Kavati Vidya.
How do you... You really can't log on to this boss? You 100% serious with me?
You can. It's not a great idea.
What is the great idea? Like...
Just run, doing hit and run tactics and stuff is decent for this one. Not really much of a dodge and roll. He doesn't really have like a melee swing for you to dodge roll out of. So like you're, if you're in his path of his rampage, you're kind of in trouble. It's like going a hit and run and attacking his legs or in the recover of his attacks and stuff is often a great idea. But be careful because anything about him might be able to attack. Like he probably hits you with his tail sooner or later. So you'd want to be able to be careful to block that just in case and stuff.
Oh, he's turning around.
Yep, and he's in his slam mode. That's such a cool visual.
Well, you gotta get a little bit closer there, buddy.
That is such a cool visual.
Come on.
Yeah, he'll eventually try to slam on you. You just have to be very careful. Here it comes. Oh, he's going up. Uh-oh. Roll. Oh.
I tried. I honestly
almost
did. I can promise you I tried to roll.
Yeah. I'm not accusing you of not trying.
No, I know. I'm saying
it just means
just,
the timing's just not
quite there.
Sometimes
the game just is like, not today, Satan.
Well, it's not the game screwing you over. It's just the timing was wrong.
Okay.
Oh, there it goes. You either roll too early and then you like are stupidly on the ground and get destroyed, or you roll too late and you have the fun moment of, I rolled, I fucking rolled, and it didn't do it. Which is what happens when you're present too late. Fuck, you want to get his tail off?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You said it gives me shit.
Generally, yeah, if a thing has a tail, you can knock its tail off, and it gets a weapon. I don't necessarily remember what this one is specifically, but I assume his tail comes off since that's like what this game's known for, but I put my...
Oh, I got an Estus flask.
My phone's a timer right now, so I
Thanks.
Can't do that. Yay! Free flask. The good news is you do a bunch of damage, so...
Yeah, I'm doing an adequate amount of damage when I'm close to him.
Yeah. The only reason you're not doing a lot of damage right now is you're mostly trying to hit his tail, which is harder to hit than the rest of his body. There you go, Dragon King Great Axe. Isn't that the coolest sounding shit ever?
That sounds great.
And hey, if you die, you still have it.
Yeah, that sounds like a 10 out of 10
even
weapon.
Even if you die and start the fight over, his tail's gone now, and you got his weapon.
All right, buddy, let's actually fight.
So you kind of have this fight down already, honestly. Uh-oh.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Maybe let's not hug.
You do not want to be in front of this guy, generally. So now that you know not to be in front of him, the primary risk is just getting hit by his flying.
Ow! What?
Oh, he's doing a tantrum. Maybe just stay away from that. So my advice, if he flies again, Andrew,
yeah.
Just fucking run for it.
I'm just going to run below him.
No, not below him. Run far, far away from him if he flies. Because he's going to slam. And you can't really tell where he's going. So if you can run, yeah. Oh, shit.
I can't tell where he's going because I can't lock onto him.
That's, yeah.
Oh,
that's,
good. Yeah, good.
That mostly comes down to camera skill. He tried to tail attack you, but he doesn't have one.
Oh, that's...
He broke his tail off and he can't hit you with it anymore. There you go.
That's the lesson you learn from...
So, yeah, that's a skill to work on over time, is manipulating the camera while playing. Is that you start being able to pick up like where a guy is that's in the air. So you might not get this attempt, but you're getting there. Let's see, are you ever blocking at all?
No.
You should two-hand then. If you're never blocking, you then there's no reason to use a shield.
Stop! You can't. You don't have a tail anymore.
Because you might be able to block. Oh, he's gonna tail whip you.
With what?
It was like a bump. It was like embarrassing tiny damage. Whoa, run! Oh shit!
I can't.
Camera manipulation.
Well, I mean, for starters, you know he's in front of you, and so he's flying from there, which means run the opposite direction, and he won't be above you yet, and then you can run that way. Like, it's fairly logical.
Yeah, but
like... he's directly in front of you, he starts flying, that means run backwards, and he won't be above you. Just be careful for any follow-up. You're getting it. Like, this is it. You could easily beat this boss fight if you had, like, a flask.
Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god!
And there's enough space in this fight, there's so much opening, that you could actually risk it other things. Because, there's so much space, you could almost use a humanity to heal. If you use a humanity, you get a full heal. Watch out.
What do I do? Go.
Running.
Go.
Don't fall off the cliff, by the way.
I know there's a cliff.
Did I tell you that before? That if you use a humanity, it
fully
heals you?
No, but that's a good thing to know.
Yeah. It's not advised usually, but this is like the specific case is that, oh, I can casually open my inventory for a bit because the boss is super far away and I'm probably safe from him for like 10 seconds at a time if I run across the whole level.
Yeah.
So if you run across the whole level and you could like equip humanity on your Estus meter, and then you could just use humanity to heal if you really want to, but that's a humanity you're not getting back, so it'll add it to your counter, so that you keep that part, but it's not, you're not getting the hard humanity back until you get more drops.
Nice try.
You're beating the gaping dragon. You're actually like doing good despite all the other
No.
Oh, that's he's throwing a tantrum. You're lucky.
Yeah. But I don't want to be also in that tantrum because I have no S's flasks.
No, I'm saying you're lucky because it wasn't a slam.
Yeah.
Because if it was a slam, you were in the hitbox and that was bad time. You might not need to heal again.
Don't be so sure about yourself.
You're doing really well. You've got his patterns down.
Take off your hand. Can I do that?
Nah. If he just can't walk around anymore. It's one of the when he's charging, don't enter his hitbox at all, by the way.
Well, yeah.
Don't even like chase it from behind. I think you can still get hit.
Yeah, that's wait until he's down. Yeah. So you're going to do it again, right? Here comes the jump.
This is pretty good. When I was a noob doing my first playthrough on the channel, I'm pretty sure I had some trouble with this guy. Shit. Yep. That's what you do. You just run from him. He has a maximum distance.
Body slam.
I think why your strategy from earlier didn't work when you're like when you said to run below him. I think he had drops if you enter his hitbox.
Ow! What the fuck? No, get out of his leg.
You're okay. It was chip.
No,
damage.
I know. I
it's
was just,
chip damage.
I just hate when you try to do that. And it's like, eh.
Oh, it's so close. Oh, it's so close. One hit. Oh, there it is. 520. You just beat Gaping Dragon on your first try.
What is the command?
Oh, select? It gets covered with the humanity notification. You're hugging the notification like you're so happy it's there. 25,000 souls.
I guess I could buy that shortcut now.
25,000 souls!
Is that... I did.
Time to head on back.
Is that what you wanted, you stupid loser-ass motherfucker?
You fucking did
fucking it. PvP-ass loser.
Now you get to experience one of the other infamous zones soon. So congrats on that.
Yay.
So
why is there acid everywhere?
That's just the goop. This is a goopy pool. It's full of goop. You didn't have to summon.
Weakness head.
You just beat Capra Demon and Gaping Dragon on your first tries without summoning.
But Keith, I'm not playing the game the way it's meant to be played.
That's not... It's good to show contempt for your audience. let's head back to Weird Vendor Man.
This will just go back? Yeah.
You just got the key to that.
Oh, the key to the gate?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's Blighttown.
Blighttown.
Yeah, it's infamous.
How
its
delightful
name
of a name!
It. Yeah, it's right here. Isn't that convenient? Hello, sir.
Oh, I guess I don't need to talk to him. Do I?
Unless you just like him. Okay. Well, because you Swami or something.
Welcome to Blighttown.
Man, we're going to have a great time next session.
Oh no,
I say
why is it all
maybe
green?
Sarcastically.
Is that supposed to be like that? Or
yeah, it's Blighttown. It's green.
Is there a bonfire? Nearby at least?
Maybe. Let's not risk it. Unless you want a homeward bone or something. So it might be time to stop.
I agree, but that's why I want to fucking the good luck. Thanks.
You can just log out here and you'll keep your souls.
Well, I just respawn at a bonfire?
You'll respawn here.
Oh.
You did that this session. You spawned
oh,
into the
right,
Titanite Demon Chamber.
You're right. Okay, we'll do this next time.
Next
Goodbye.
Time, guys. Blighttown. It's going to have all the frames. So many frames.
And blights. So many blights.
So many blights. Please log out.